I think that I shall never see a poem as lovely as a tree. Joyce Kilmer wrote that, and he did very well with it. In fact, there's a rest stop on the Jersey Turnpike named after him, and that trumps any Pulitzer in my book. But I think that the sentiment that he expresses is a common one. We often feel the inadequacy of written language to express reality. In fact, I think that perhaps the last 3,000 years of literary history is a long elegiac wail for a time when poems were not seen, but heard. A time when a bard might have intoned, I think that I shall never hear a tree as lovely as a poem. A time before the open, eternal hexameter of Homer was truncated a foot into the written pentameter line. A time when lines were conceived and spoken in one breath. And so this is a chapter from a book-length poem that you've been listening to over the last four residencies called To Banquet with the Worthy Ethiopians, a memoir of life before the alphabet, about a scrivener, or a writer, if you will, who keeps a list of everything that happens and does not. And the chapter is called Pente. The keeping of a secret inventory is, of course, itself a notable thing, and so recorded. Is the list real? Inside my head, does the catalog throb blood or staunch the wound? Folded in Fagel's Iliad, Book 2, brindled foolscap of assiduously numbered cave figures and totems, record my jihads and shillelagh laws, star chambers and soap operas. Item, a provost spears my groin. Item, the aegis of a sorority is pierced. The list slithers, whiptails into memoir. Or so it did for years between moon and cup, till my heart tried to burn its ilium. Parting my gown, Agamemnon traced in livid script a fey sentence, Pente. Against morphine, I strained to count from 5. Gram, gon, ex, tuk, angle. How long had I been dead? How long to live? Heart stopped, I never left the room. Or stayed. No dream, no prophecy, no sign of Father Telemachus. Thus I take to heart the word of Agamemnon, Pente. Not an obsessive inventory, sculpting every potent unshaped hour, nor the unlettered chant of wind-notch vowel, swelling and diminishing in duration, the way the child composed a rocking house. Between the open hex of serf's utterance and the plain English of my secret list, enter a parenthesis, Pente. Inside its syllabic walls, I pace to 5. Step 1, be born. The hind foot pairs, pirouettes, kicks uncouples. Foot 3, the chirograph unseals. Toes cleave to a cliff printing blood over a deep caesura. Many fall. Others turn back, but those who bridge with elevated speech onto the pentultimate foot, the psychostasia, they weigh hearts. Having stepped into my chest, the fourth foot finds me light, flensed of fear and lust. Pente, the fifth foot, knows it is last, is not redeemable by surf or sky. It faces down the margin, quavers slightly. Beyond the fifth, nothing. The blank page, aching to be born. For twice 5 years in the space Homer forgot between the Aegean and Troy's palisade, the Argives put one foot before another, but got nowhere. Under the tireless sun, heroes proceeded with war cries, attacks, retreats, spear thrusts, twanging bows, but no victory or defeat. No one died or lived, as if they had been bronzed. As if when Homer cut out 50 days to carve a text, 50,000 hearts unsheathed, a field of dead muscle oozing Plavix's blood until the surf coagulated into Achilles' rage. No memoir, no chanting hexameter. As if they had spent those years at the police camp, in the great beamed clubhouse where Odysseus juggles 5 bladder-heavy balls and sets them down between contending armies. According to Warball's ancient protocol, finger or foot must touch the home base wall until released. Meatless arms outstretched, they claw the air, Trojans and Argives. Finally, Agamemnon whistles and the armies dash, stamping hard wood. At 5 body lengths apart, they freeze, as if arrested by a god or smashing into 2 invisible walls. The enemies glare. The war ball dance begins. Stress, unstress, caesura, penta, die. Winkles faints, then fades into the ranks. Bam Bam's legs shiver like a Pentecostal or a TV on the fritz. Roto-Rooter's hand shark fins his scalp. He dives through Parboil's legs to lay 1 finger on a ball before the roar of menacing Trojan sends him scurrying. No one dares claim a liverish gourd. The balls are death. To be hit directly, winged, or even nicked, death. Bend to pick one up, and surely a volley of hurled missiles will bring death. Screaming a war cry, Anteater advances. The air sucks breath. The Argives yield. Anteater straddles the line, triumphant. He paws 2 prizes and kickrolls 2 back to brave Trojans. The fifth, he toes across the line to cowering Argives. It lies, barely wobbling, a challenge. To be hit means death, but to live without balls is to be shamed. Gulping, Floss dives for the bait. A volley of projectiles strikes his body. He falls, and Odysseus drags his corpse, groaning by the shorts from the contending field. His death enrages Argives. Armed with balls, expelled by impetuous Trojans, they attack. Volleys cross, war cries fill the gym, warriors cluster, break ranks, one triumphs, another's carted benchward where Atrides presides in zebra shirt and Laertes' son pricks dead tools for signs of life. Glassy-eyed, in camouflage fatigues, Achilles pinches from the air an emperor dragonfly, bites iridescent wings, and gnashes down. And this phantasmagoria lasts 10 years of unrelenting fury unresolved. Stress, unstress, caesura, penta, die, until the pattern is so deeply grooved it needs no more the sea or walls of Troy or air or Pleiades. Faceless, matterless, shimmeral, cadenced script. This is what finally enrages dread Achilles. Having seen in the Far East so many dead, gutted, burned, slaughtered, torn apart, to be trapped 10 years, parenthesized on a windy coast in a citadel of nothing, until regular stressed beats pound in his head like concussion of helicopter wings. Machine gun fire. Everything really happened. He rocks forward. Nothing ever happened. He rocks back. And when crazed Achilles can stand no more, he leaps out of his skull's divine armor and hurdles the first step of being born and the second step of drifting for 10 years and turns his sinewy back on Warball and receives at the third foot a fatal hit. The hero, masked as Anteater, pivots on me, bearing the aegis of Thersites. He gallops to the lip of the Caesura and fires across the chasm, against all practice, the ball that murdered him, killing Thersites from beyond the grave, entwining us in mutual life and death. And all this really happened and did not. And my secret list exists, and it does not. And Homer arrived to find Achilles dead and Troy already burned. And he arrived to find Achilles fled to the Far East, and Troy encased in 5 syllabic walls. No pentameter line was ever yet conceived and spoken in a single breath. Thank you.